Hey, what's up, y'all? My name is Javon Hillwood. Happy Black History Month. Glad to be celebrating this month with you guys. We have a rich history. I'm here to talk to you guys today about pen. Not this type of pen. This is the type of pen you may be thinking about, but that's not what we're talking about today. We're talking about this type of pen. The sound might actually sound familiar. You may have heard it before. It makes you think about the Little Mermaid, maybe, Caribbean islands like Jamaica. So the instrument is actually from the island of Trinidad and Tobago, from the descendants of African-American slaves. It's something that really came out of the slums, or as we would say here in America, the hood. To some extent, affiliated with gang culture as well. It spread and everybody saw the beauty in it, and it became this great thing. Early pioneers of the instrument were Ellie Mennett, Winston Spree Simon, Rudy King, who is responsible for bringing the pen to the Americas. Also, Russ Henderson, who was known for being one of the founders of Nottingham Carnival, a popular carnival in England. I grew up playing, usually we play by ear, which is very customary in African-American traditions. So today, pen is played all over the world. We have pen players from Japan, pen players from Australia, pen players from New York, anywhere in the world, you name it. Pen is everywhere now. It's actually also the only acoustic instrument created in the 20th century. So that's a fun fact. Steel pan is actually probably used in a lot of your favorite songs. So I'll play some clips of the songs for you guys, and I'll also play it on the pan so maybe you can recognize the parts with your ear. Some of my favorites, Fake Love by Drake. By Travis Scott, that's one of my favorite popular songs. There's a possibility that all of y'all probably know this one. That's ZZ by Kodak Black featuring Travis Scott. Even in some songs by your favorite pop star like Ariana Grande. This is off of her new album Positions, and the song is called My Hair. You can hear the pen in the background here as well. Pianist is a term that we call steel pan players or steel drummer, but more commonly steel pan. I think, you know, when it got to America or other places, they get a little bit more technical and call it a drum, but really we from the culture, like us Trinidadians and Caribbean folk, we simply call it pan or steel pan. I guess I'm a part of Black history myself. I was actually the first pianist to be accepted into LaGuardia's jazz program. LaGuardia's a performing arts high school here in New York City. Back in the day, they used to march with steel pans like around their neck like this. Carnival, which is a huge celebration in the Caribbean, just of celebrating life, celebrating culture, and obviously pen is a huge part of that. So this was one of the ways they used to march back in the day, play the pen. Modern day, typically steel pen is played on a stand, which I'm gonna put it on for you guys, man. So this is the steel pen on a stand. These are the sticks. They're also known as mallets. So these are the sticks that we play pan with. The steel pan has become very versatile and can play any form of music from jazz to R&B to country to calypso and soca where it started off. I'm gonna play this reggae vibe for you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the history lesson. Without further ado, I'm gonna perform this song called Toast by Coffee. You guys may know it. Hope you enjoy it. All right. guys. Hope you guys enjoyed. Also, this headband I'm wearing is from Trinidad and Tobago. My family's from Trinidad and Tobago, and this is where the instrument originated. Happy Black History Month.